Good morning, this is Susan. I'm getting ready to paint in oils this morning. Thought I would broadcast it live in case you're interested in watching. Do we have any painters out there? Hi, who is that? Aldi? Andy? Nikki? I'm mixing up some paint back here. My palette this morning is Cad Yellow Deep, Cad Red Medium, White, Black, and ultramarine blue, and I'm mixing up some black and yellow, that cad yellow deep, to make me a beautiful green. And I'm just gonna kind of work that in my background. I like for my corners to be darker and for it to lighten up in the middle of the painting. Just so it gives more of a spotlight on the focus of the painting. So this is my black and cad yellow deep mixture. Hi there, who is that? Is that Millie? Y'all gonna have to help me with these names. Looks like there's a Roddy, an Andy, a Walt. Thanks for joining me. Why are y'all not working today? Here we go. Now, I'm just going to take some plain yellow. Well, it's kind of plain yellow. I've messed it up a little bit with that black, but I'm going to just kind of work that in. See how that's lighter? We're just going to try to make it get a little bit lighter as it comes toward that subject. It's kind of like a little natural spotlight when you do that. And I'm not really using any brush stroke in particular. Some people call that the scrub in. I think of a scrub as a little bit more, I don't know, a little rougher and not quite as that control. These are just more crisscross strokes. I'd already blocked in my basic shape. I use a software program or an app called Value Viewer. And it puts a grid on my photos so that I'm able to block in those shapes better. It also helps me distinguish my my values better. I'm gonna do a new technique today that I haven't demonstrated before, but it's one that I do use, and that's a softening technique using a tissue. Thank you for the hearts. I appreciate that. Okay, there we go with our background. I started out with kind of a burnt sienna toning of the canvas, and I didn't use burnt sienna. I actually just mixed yellow, blue, and red together, using a little more red and yellow, which created my own burnt sienna. And now I'm going to take a tissue, and of course a tissue is square. I'm going to grab it in the middle like that, so it has lots of ends, and just kind of whoosh it over this, softening those brush strokes. Kind of makes for a dreamy, soft edge effect on your background. Sometimes I do this at the end of my painting as well, just to move the color around. I'm not using a lot of pressure. Just kind of lightly going over that. I'm also going to switch to a green made out of blue and yellow. And add it different places just to give the illusion that there's something else going on back there. Maybe add a little bit of white to that. Soften those edges just a little bit. And then just leave it alone. Usually you want your background to just be really soft and feathery anyway. That way it doesn't detract from the subject of your painting. I'm gonna clean that brush really good. I'm using odorless mineral spirits on my brush and a paper towel to pull out that extra color. Oh, and where do we want to start? I think we'll take some white, mix in just the tiniest bit of blue. Kind of lay a foundation layer here of where I might want the white. This is going to be a little chickadee. If you want something white, you can't paint it white because you have to reserve that extra lightness and brightness for your highlights. So you have to figure out another color, and usually it's going to be a cool blue or a warm yellow. And I'm going with a cool blue this morning. And I can always put white on top of that and pull out some highlight. I'm going to add a little purple to that, which is red and blue mixed together. But I want to keep it on the blue side, which isn't hard because that ultramarine blue is just so incredibly thick with pigment. It just takes a little bit because it does lean everything to the blue side. Just a little. This is actually white as well, but it's in shadow, so I'm going to darken it up some. And that's a cool shadow. And then we're going to have a little warmer shadow over here. And this was just on my palette, just some Gerberi color greenish color. I didn't mix this, or I did, but it's been a while. I haven't cleaned my palette up in several days. Okay, that's a good background. In fact, I may give a little highlight over here in the greenish color and then also in the bluish. In fact, I wasn't going to work on that branch right now, but I like that green color for the branch. So we're going to put a little bit of it on the branch. I used to think trees were brown until I started painting, and then I realized they're probably every color but brown. A lot of blue-gray and green-gray. I'll just put that in there for right now. I just added a dot of black to that blue shadow color because I wanted to get it a little bit darker. In certain places, so I'm just adding on more layers and maybe a little more detail, if you will. That same color is light in shadow or white in shadow, and I put it over here to be black in sunlight. It's the exact same color. One of the, just put a full black on there this time. I'm just gonna run a little bit of that in there. One of the hardest things to realize is that black in light can actually be lighter in value than white in shadow. I'm beginning to look like a little chickadee. And I want to lighten this up a little bit. I'm going to add that black to that green right there. And see if we can't lighten that up some. Not only is there some light on the bird, but there would be some green reflecting off of it with all this green around there. I think I've lost that eye. I have to come back and do some detail on that, but for right now we'll just leave it. I'm going to use that dark down here as well. It's the same color as what is up here. Most people don't understand when they're painting is that getting the value right is more important than getting the color right. And you never want to overwork your painting, but sometimes you do have to go back and adjust value to just get it to where you need it to be. Okay. That's straight white. Do I paint every day? That's a good question. And the answer is most every day. I can't say I paint every single day, but when I'm not in the studio painting, I'm usually out teaching or doing demonstrations, so it's not unusual for me to teach every day or to paint every day. I'm thickening up my paint a little bit now. I don't know if you can tell that or not. But we generally want it to be really thin in areas that are not in focus. And then we build up in our area of focus. Oops, I kind of messed that up. Let me see if I can get some of that off.
I feel so absolutely stumped on the floor. When you dance, you're charming and you're gentle, especially when you do that kind of.
I'm going to, well, it's going to move to a smaller brush, but I think I'm going to use this one to add some highlights. I'm going to move to this tiny little brush to add a little sparkle to the bird's eye. And I think that's too big, so I'm going to use that same little brush to try to reshape that eye. Maybe even paint in what I would call the negative shape to get that little sparkle smaller. Don't usually like using brushes this small. I bought this one to be able to sign my name.
For heaven rest, I am not.
Okay. I'm probably about 90% through now. This is the first few stages right there real quick. I paint in stages or phases or passes. The first pass is to make a decision regarding the underpainting. And the decision may be not to do an underpainting. Or you can do a tone, which is a real thin wash over your white canvas, which is really good to get it into a medium value. Or you can actually go the colorist approach and pencil in or block in your shape in a blue pastel pencil. And then you do your underpainting in the darker colors that you see that you're going to build on and make them more vibrant. Today, I chose to do an underpainting in a burnt umber, kind of the toneless approach, I guess. And I don't want that little dot right there. And so we did the underpainting, and then we moved into the block in. And I almost did that in one step, but usually your block in is step number two. You block in your basic shape. And then once you're happy with that, then you move to what we call the scrub in. And I didn't exactly scrub, but it's basically getting your colors in. You just want to kind of scrub in the basic colors. And I started with the background first, which I normally do. And then I came back with a tissue to kind of soften those edges. I like that background to be darker around the edges, especially in the corners. And I like it to be either dappled or just really plain. I don't want to take away from the focal point of my painting, so I don't usually have a real busy background. And if I do, because one of the challenges I have is to eliminate what's in the background. So what I try to do is either make it a more neutral color or real soft edges, just to say it's back there, but don't pay attention to it. And then the focal point is where I put all my attention and start building up the color and move to the next step, which is where it goes from what I call a pretty picture to a masterpiece. It's where the magic happens. And that next step is where you start adding your detail. Now, I'm an impressionist painter, so I don't add a lot of detail, but I love little highlight in the eye. I might even come back and try to work on that beak a little bit more, because I really want this to be the focal point of the painting. Not just the bird as a whole, but the face of the bird. So I may come back and bring that up just a little bit. At this point, I also like to add more paint. I like heavier paint in this pass. We want to build that up just to give it some texture and some depth. This is just straight white, which I don't usually use straight white, but you know, there's some real good highlights on this bird, so we may just use some straight white. And then the last pass is simply to sign your name, and you're done. Now, I don't usually sign my name at this point because I do want to do a little more work to it, but I want to show you something I discovered. It's called a color shaper, and this happens to be a number 6. They come in different types of points or tips, and this one's nice because if I goofed on this, I could just scrape that paint right off and be real specific where I scrape it off so I don't mess up the whole painting. But I also love it because it's got that nice tip. I can just sign my name. As if it's my signature. Try doing that with a brush and paint. It's not easy. I do teach quite a bit, and my students just struggle with signing their names with a paintbrush and paint. I won't let them use a paint pen, but I don't mind them using this little gizmo. It doesn't work as well with acrylic, but in oils it works really, really well. Thanks for joining me. If you like my paintings, you're welcome to go to my website and see more of them at susanejones.com. If you're in the Middle Tennessee area and want to take a class, I teach in about 7 different counties, and those classes are listed at paintingwithsusan.com. Thanks for joining me.